On paper, NASA has surprisingly few job requirements for its astronauts. An astronaut needs a master's degree in a STEM field and 2 years of related experience, and they need to pass a pretty rigorous physical test. And that's it! But these are astronauts. They tend to go above and beyond. So here are a few things that aren't on that list: having a doctorate in engineering, co-inventing technology that people will still use almost 30 years later, teaching computers to think with light instead of electricity, being good enough to be a classical flautist, and being cool enough to play a flute in space. That was the resume of just one applicant in 1990, Ellen Ochoa, who is awesome, in case you haven't realized it. Ellen Ochoa grew up in Southern California and considered going to school for music until she caught the bug for physics. She became an electrical engineer and studied optics, or the way that light interacts with materials. Some of her research focused on how to make basic parts of a computer work with light instead of electricity, which is something engineers are still working on today. The thinking is that light doesn't interfere with itself as much as electrical signals do, so you can cram more different messages into the same space with light than you can with electricity. But mostly, Ochoa wasn't trying to build computers with light, she was trying to understand pictures with light. Which might sound weird. I mean, a picture is made up of light. Like, if there's no light, there's nothing for you to see. So how else would you understand it? But how your eyes see an image is not the same as how it looks to a computer. To a computer, an image is a big grid of numbers. A certain amount of light from this pixel, a certain amount of light from that pixel, and so on. To a computer, an image isn't all that different from a spreadsheet. And to a computer, looking for patterns in that picture means comparing every single pixel to the pixels around it, and to the pixels around the pixels around it. That is a nightmare, especially for the computers of 1985. So Ochoa was looking at what's called optical image processing, which uses the actual light from an image, not the spreadsheet of pixels. The light is put through filters that can do things like increase the contrast or highlight the edges. She and her colleagues invented a way to scan the templates that get used to make computer chips for defects, so that those defects don't make it into the chips themselves. Today, this technique gets used a lot in medicine. Computers can have a hard time finding the edges of something, like a cell, which can look a lot like its surroundings. But with the right filters, cells, organs, and tissues can all pop right out. The newly minted Dr. Ellen Ochoa was not interested in biology, though her sights were fixed a couple hundred kilometers above the rest of us. So in 1987, she applied to be an astronaut. And she was rejected, along with 1,000 other applicants. But Ochoa isn't one to give up. She got her pilot's license to make herself a stronger candidate for the next round, and she kept studying images, now as a professional engineer. Ochoa invented ways for computers to check multiple pictures and realize that they are all of the same object. Armed with that fact, the computer could stitch together a clearer visual of the object than any one picture revealed on its own. And that is exactly what you would want if you are, say, a space agency with a million pictures of Saturn's moons, and you want to know if blips in the pictures are interesting craters or boring static. Or if your robot is about to land on Mars and it needs to figure out on its own whether it's about to land on a single giant rock or a bunch of small ones. And so, after NASA rejected another astronaut application from her in 1987, Dr. Ochoa went to work for NASA as an engineer. By 1990, she'd published over a dozen papers about optics and image processing, co-filed 3 patents, and was at the head of a team of 35 other scientists and engineers. And despite 2 attempts, she had still never been to space. But that was about to change. NASA finally accepted her application, and on April 8, 1993, at just after 1:30 in the morning, Ellen Ochoa became the first Hispanic woman in space. While she was up there, Ochoa and her crewmates conducted a bunch of experiments to understand how solar activity affects Earth's weather and climate. And they also radioed in to schools around the world to talk about what life is like in orbit. Almost 20 years after she chose physics over fluting, it was only fitting that Ellen Ochoa was part of yet another first on that shuttle mission. She was the first person to ever play the flute in space. Ochoa went back to space 3 more times and did all the awesome stuff astronauts do. She brought supplies to the International Space Station while it was being built, she studied the sun more, she spacewalked for 8 hours, she used the station's robotic arm to drag satellites and astronauts around in space. Then, with both feet firmly back on the ground, Dr. Ochoa became deputy director of Johnson Space Center and later its first Hispanic director, where she was finally the one in charge of choosing astronauts. Today, Ellen Ochoa continues speaking to audiences around the world, but her name might sound a bit familiar to you for another reason. Schools all around the United States are named after this incredible woman, and if you went to one of those schools, you are part of that legacy too. Thanks for watching this episode of SciShow, and thanks, as always, to the amazing community of patrons who make it possible. If you would like to get involved, you can head over to patreon.com/scishowspace.